Hello everyone, welcome back to part 17 of our Endless Runner tutorial series. Today, I'll be addressing some known issues. I haven't covered some issues because I have not found a way to fix them, or they don't affect the gameplay. Now, let's get started. There are two main issues that affect the gameplay, and to demonstrate them, I'm disabling the spawning of obstacles and coins. Additionally, I have set the character speed to 1000. You don't have to do any of this. Now, the first issue that we have is the character moving to the wrong lane when switching lanes fast. This happens because when we are in the middle lane and try to switch to the right lane and then immediately try to switch back to the middle lane, instead of switching to the middle lane, the character will switch to the left lane because the current lane position hasn't been updated yet. The other issue is the speed of the slide animation. Most of you have noticed that when a character slides at high speed, the character slows down to play the sliding animation. To fix the first issue where the character switches to the wrong lane when switching lanes fast, in Unreal Engine, open the BP_Runner character blueprint. Create a new variable called isSwitchingLanes and set the type to Boolean. In the changeLanes custom event, from the setActorLocation node, add setIsSwitchingLanes and tick the box. Also, from the setCurrentLaneIndex variable connected to the timeline node, add setIsSwitchingLanes and keep it unchecked. Now, select the changeLanes nodes connected to enhanced input action nodes and move them a little further. From the triggered pin of the enhanced input action node, add a branch node. From the variable tab, drag and drop isSwitchingLanes and select getIsSwitchingLanes. Now, connect the variable to the branch node and connect the false pin of the branch node to the changeLanes node. Now, do the same for the other enhanced input action node. Compile and save. Go to the level and press play. You can see that when I try to switch lanes quickly, the character doesn't switch to the wrong lane like before. Now, the next issue that we are going to fix is the slowdown of the slide animation. Go to the content browser and then go to the folder where your character sliding animations are located. Right-click in the empty area, go to Animation, then Legacy, and select Blend Space 1D. Then, select your character skeleton and name it bs_your_character_name_slide. Open the Blend Space. From the Asset Browser tab, drag and drop the slide animation to the graph and move it to the start. Now, in the Asset Details tab on the left, in the horizontal axis, set the name to speed and the maximum value to 500. Again, drag and drop the slide animation from the asset browser and move it to the end of the graph. Save it. You have to do this for all the characters that you are using. I'm also using CC4 Kevin and Camila, so I will the same for both of the characters. For UE5 Manny and Quinn, you only have to do it once with the UE5 mannequin skeleton. Once you have created blend spaces for all characters, go to the content browser and open the animation blueprint of the character. Once you've opened the animation blueprint, go to the anim graph. If you don't see anim graph, go to the My Blueprints tab on the left and click on anim graph to open it. In anim graph, open the locomotion state machine. Now, click on the walk/run state border, and when it turns a different color, drag it out and then add a state, naming it slide. Now, drag the arrow from slide to walk/run to create a transition. Double-click on the icon with two arrows beside the arrow from walk to slide to add a new transition rule. In My Blueprints tab, create a new variable called as sliding and set the type to Boolean. Drag and drop the variable onto the Boolean pin of the result node inside the transition rule. Now, open the transition rule of the arrow connecting from slide to walk, add get as sliding, from it add not Boolean, and connect it to the result node. Go back to locomotion and open slide state. From the asset browser, drag and drop bs_slide that we created earlier. From the speed pin, add get ground speed. Now, go to the event graph, select the sequence node, and add a new pin to it. From the new sequence pin, add cast to bp_runner character. From the object pin, add get player character. As runner character, add get as sliding. And from the variables tab, add set as sliding and connect the get as sliding pin to set as sliding. Compile and save. Do the same for other characters' animation blueprints. Finally, open bp_runner character blueprint. In the event graph, delete play montage as well as the nodes connected to play montage nodes. Then connect set as sliding execution pin to the delay node. Also, increase the delay to 1 second. Compile and save. Go to the level and press play. As you can see, now the sliding animation speed matches the speed of the character running. Now for the third issue, many people have emailed me and messaged me on Discord that when they press escape to trigger the pause menu, the game quits. This is because Unreal Engine, by default, quits the game when escape is pressed in the editor. To fix it, in Unreal Engine, click on Edit on top, then select Editor Preferences. Go to Keyboard Shortcuts. From the search bar, search for Stop. In the Keyboard Shortcuts section, look for Play World and the word Stop below it. If the key binding is empty or it says escape, then remove the binding, then click on it to add a new binding, then press Shift plus Escape. Now, to quit the game, you have to press Shift plus Escape, and the game won't quit when you press Escape. Now, the fourth issue is when the character slides below the obstacle, the camera glitches with the obstacle. It's really easy to fix. Go to your character blueprint. In the viewport, from the Components tab, select Spring Arm or Camera Boom, and in the Details tab, disable Do Collision Test. Compile and save the blueprint. This will fix the issue. And that's it for today's video. I hope you found this tutorial helpful. If you encounter any errors or need assistance, feel free to contact me via email or Discord. You can find the details in the description. If you enjoyed the video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.